Napakalawak ng mundo, napakaraming bansa, iba't ibang lahi. Pero ang isang nag-uugnay sa atin ay ang ating karagatan. Sabi nga, there are so many countries, but we only have one ocean. The Coral Triangle is a marine area located in the Western Pacific Ocean. It hosts an astonishing amount of marine life. A 100 million people are dependent on the Coral Triangle for food, sources of livelihood, and even protection from storms. Coming from this island, being an islander, we all depend on marine and coastal environments for our survival. The reefs are important because the majority of the population here are fishermen, and the people here rely on the bounty that we harvest from the sea. It gives food to their tables, and it's also their source of living. This project is huge. Coming from this island, being born in this island, so I can see that there is really a great potential for the corals to recover and be better than what it was before. Working on the reef rehabilitation project, it's part of my job, really, but this is home for me. But unfortunately, 97% of our coral reefs are under threat. This is why B2Gold's Masbate Gold project has become an active leader in environmental stewardship here in the Philippines. Aroroy, which is found in the island of Masbate and also where I was born, the destructive methods of fishing like cyanide fishing, dynamite fishing, and even overfishing have greatly damaged the coral habitat and decimated the fish stocks.
Amo ni pagahimo ko sa pisto. Ako na ini asimbulon. Ini siya irog na sini siya, iniipit ini siya. Pag-ipit ko, aminin na pumutok.
Tapos, tapos ko pagpamana. Aminin siyang pinaka-ipit.
Ito ang ini ng blasting cap. Butang nga po siya sa plastic.
Plastic para dili mabasa.
Dili mabasa sa dagat.
Lagay sa rubber.
Pwede na ba sa bugon?
Tapos,
pwede na ba sa bugon? Yan o, pwede na.
Sabrita na?
Sige.
Oo. Bata pa. Damo pa talaga kay medyo tayo pa nagpag-isda. Talagang damo pa niyong makita na mga isda, coral, kuha ang pagit siya, buo pa. Yan sa nagagamit na, sa mga sign hadi na mita na, medyo talaga nag-bar down ng mga corals.
Pag may nagagipaw ang isda dida, ginamita.
Wala kami iba na kung talaga hanap buhay, amo talaga yun ang buno. Pagpasabog sa dagat.
Nagsimula noong September 2017, kung saan pinagplanuhan ng Aroroy at saka ng Mineral Resources Corporation kung ano ang maganda para sa environment ng Aroroy. Ang magandang nangyari dito is unang-una na-control natin yung blast fishing in the area. So, ngayon nga, hindi pa umabot ng isang taon, meron na tayong nakita na maraming corals na tumubo. So, nag-regenerate yung corals natin. So, ang tao naman ay, they accept the project. Ibang project ito. Hindi lang basta marine protected area. Mayroon tayong inintroduce na bagong technology na pwedeng gawing aralan.
I'm an environmentalist by heart. I see it as not just like a job, but more like a passion to protect the environment. So at first it was a challenge diving. But when I came to see those little critters and how awesome they are underwater, and also knowing that it's only few people can see that, it's just an amazing work to do. Reefball modules, these are designed to withstand strong waves or surge when there are typhoons. So it's made of concrete. The bottom of it also is designed to bury itself in the sand so it doesn't move. The reefball modules are the homes for the fishes. But since we're going to revive the marine ecosystem, we need corals also. We have the coral of opportunities. These are corals that were damaged by typhoon or blasting. So they're just there lying on the bottom of the sea. So we collect those corals and then we plant them in coral plugs. Those coral plugs are now attached to the reef balls because the corals grow on its own. They're alive, so it will attach itself to the reef ball. So fish will just swim around them. In 5 years, it's gonna be a huge difference from the rubbles to like a garden of corals. And in just 3 to 4 months, it's growing like a centimeter. And the survival of corals is 80%. And so it's really growing. The sea is helping itself, but we also need intervention. We need to help them out to really hasten the recovery of the marine ecosystem. This project, the MPA, is first in the region to be supported by private sector. What more if we have other MPAs and just support it? Now, when we go diving and can say that fishes are all around us, sometimes we just swim around them and we play with them.
Kaya nga niyo, ito na sa pagbutang dito, damo na isda na naga, ano, damo na nagasulod na isda. Dida, dida sila yung butang tanang mga ano, damo na na isda naga surulod-surulod sa mga buo, sa mga Red Bull.
Pag aga, sir, eh, simpe, kitao na muna ang mga ilan taon naman ang mga sitwasyon sa mga buya. Yan, kita naman kung may mga lansya nga nag-aagi, baruto, na base magsulod sa MPA, amin ang ginakuha na naman pag abot sa aga. O, yung nag-aagi, sir, pag malinaw talaga, makita nin dan isda nga damo-damo na talaga makita nga pasisari. Nagasiriyak sinda sin, oh, damo ni isda.
Sabi ko, ayoko niyan. Pag kami lang, hindi namin kaya yan. Pero pag may filminera tayo nakasama, kakayanin namin yan. That's why na-put up ito. Pag yun ang pagtutulungan, walang iwanan. Thank you very much.
P2 Gold, as we know, is a highly successful mining company. We find, acquire, finance, build, and operate mines at an international level. And that's what we do, but that really doesn't say how we do it. The values that we bring to the table are fairness, respect, accountability, and transparency. Nowhere on the mine site are you without a vision of the ocean. And we've been able to incorporate an environmental policy that really has an aspect of running from ridge to reef. With that in mind, we initiated a program that involved purchasing defunct fish farms, turning areas into mangroves, which provide a nursery for small fish. We've planted more than 750,000 mangroves in the time that we're here. And we worked on that project with the support and coordination with the local community. So all of the work we do, it really has a local sense of ownership.
Filminera is a local company, it's a Philippine-based company. It's registered as a mining company here. It's the one that owns the tenements here in Masbate, and also it owns the local permits here in the Philippines. Sometimes it takes will for the company to think further, to think through, to think long-term. For example, the reef ball and the mangrove, these projects have far-reaching long-term implications. When the company is gone, maybe generations from now, these projects will still be there. These are the projects that people of that generation, of the future generations, will remember.
Whenever I'm home, I tell my niece and nephews, about the project that we do, so that I can instill in their minds that what we are doing here is really important.
I have kids and I'd like to come back here and see after a few years how it's gonna be, and I'd like to see it to be successful. I can tell my kids that, hey, I was part of this project, and it's a huge thing to be part of.
Mga anak namo, may mga anak kami, di ba? Maka kuan maka sublisin na makinabang, di ba?
You don't realize just how important it is when until you see your own staff who are locals take hold of this program with a passion to see it succeed, because they recognize the value to their community members way outside of what we're doing and way into the future. They're not going anywhere, whereas we may go up and develop a mine somewhere else, but they know that they're staying in this area. So that's potentially a transportable skill, and you'll have a core group of people here with that education and development that can take those skills and start teaching elsewhere. So there's potentially huge multiplier effects from what we're doing.
Siyempre.
Ano problem? Okay lang trabaho na.
Mamo Kobo.